Dear students, welcome and thank you for tuning in to this video. We are continuing our discussion in the sex and dynamics. This is the last lecture of chapter 3, equilibrium of a particle, with me, Dr. Loay Alzube. And we're going to talk in this lecture briefly about how to apply the equations of equilibrium to solve a three-dimensional statics problem. And we're going to solve a couple of practice problems. So if you have a particle and it is at equilibrium, it means that the vector sum of all forces acting on it must equal to zero. So if we have this particle here in this figure, and I have three forces, F1, F2, F3, if this particle is at equilibrium, the summation of all forces should equal to zero. To analyze this, we need to construct the equations of equilibrium. We need to write each vector in its Cartesian form, x, y, and z. And let's say, for example, for this F1, this is the x component of F1, and this is the y component, and the z component is going down, right? So you need to do the same analysis for all forces, and then we can analyze the system easily by constructing the equations of equilibrium. To simplify our work and to analyze the system, you need to write every force in its Cartesian form in x, y, z, and then you will end up with the vector equations that can satisfy the conditions that all the forces equal to zero. And these are the conditions that we need to apply. So all the forces on the x-axis should equal to zero, all the forces on the y should equal to zero, and all the forces and the z-axis should equal to zero. This will give you three equations. One, two, and three. These three equations, we call them the three scalar equations of equilibrium, and they're valid for any point in equilibrium, and it will allow us to solve for up to three unknowns in our system. And this is what we're going to use we're going to apply it in a couple of examples in order to see how this works in finding unknowns in statics. Let's start with an example. Example one. So we have this system. We have a 600 Newton load supported by three cords with the geometry as shown here in the image to the right. And let me start my pen. We are asked to find the tension in cord AB, AC, and AD. And the point A is at equilibrium. So don't forget also we have the 600, the load is that's pushing down on the negative z-axis. Before we start the analysis, I want to draw your attention to the following. See that we're going to assume all forces, our assumption, that they're going outside from the point of equilibrium. So for the force from A to C, the AC, we're going to call it the FC force here, FC. It's going along the negative x-axis, so it does not have any component on the y or the z axis. However, and also for this force, the FB force from A to B, we're going to assume that it's going outside, and we're going to call it FB. Notice that the FB force is on the xy plane, so there is no z component. And notice that we have a 30 degree angle that is a projection angle. So to analyze the system, this way we can say that the FB can be, first of all, has zero component on the z-axis. So it has a y component and the x component. The y component, you can see that the angle is off the y-axis. So I can say that this here, FB, right, cosine 30, right? And on the x-axis, the angle is not off the x-axis, so this is going to be the sine. So I can say that this is FB sine 30. Now I was able to analyze FB into two components, the x and the y component, and I don't need to use it anymore. Force from A to D, you can see that I have coordinates. So I can use the position vector. And if you recall, we have three ways to analyze three ways to write any force in its Cartesian format. So you use something called the projection angles, right? Theta and or phi, and this is one of those. Or you can use the coordinate angles. We don't have any of these here, the alpha, beta, and gamma. So those are the alpha, beta, and gamma. We're not going to use them. And the third one, so there's a three ways to write a force in its Cartesian coordinate. The third way is to use the position vector, right? And this is what actually we learned before. So here I have coordinates, the points, so I can use the position vector to find FD. So what we do actually is we write the RAD and then find the magnitude of RAD. You divide the position vector RAD by its magnitude and you multiply it by FD, and that's your position vector. So this is a quick overview of what we're going to be doing in analyzing the system and to write all forces that we draw in its in their Cartesian coordinates. Let's see what are the steps in sequence. First of all, you need to draw a free body diagram of the system of point A, and you add the unknown forces, right? We're going to call them FB, FC, and FD. As we mentioned before, we will represent each force in its Cartesian form. That's very important, IJK. And then we apply the equations to solve for the three unknowns. So you will say that summation of forces on x-axis equal to zero, summation of forces on the y-axis equal to zero, and summation of forces on the z-axis should equal to zero. And those are your equations of equilibrium. Step one, free body diagram. This is our free body diagram. And if I want just to start my pen, so for the free body diagram, this is what we have here. This is your point A, 600 going down. That's your FB, that's FC and FD. Now let's see how I'm going to write each one of those in it, their Cartesian coordinate system in IJK. So if you follow what we mentioned before, FB, I have an angle of 30. I don't have anything on the z-axis because it's on the plane of xy. The angle is off the y-axis, so this is the cosine right here. So that's going to be FB cosine 30. And on the x is FB sine 30. And that's what we have here. And you multiply it with FB because that's the magnitude, and that's your FB in IJK, in Cartesian form. FC, I have only one component. It's on the negative x-axis, so it's minus FC I, right? I don't have any projection angles, or I don't have to use any coordinate angles or the position vector for doing this. The last one, FD, as I mentioned before, we need to have the position vector AD, right? And to find the position vector RAD, so what you do is you take the point D, coordinates minus point A, coordinates, and you subtract them together and you end up with the one I. So the point D, it's in the x-axis, it's one, the y-axis, it's minus two, and the z-axis is two, and point A is 0, 0, 0. You subtract 1 minus 0, that's your 1, and minus 2 minus 0, that's minus 2, and 2 minus 0, that's 2. And to find the magnitude of RAD, you just the square of 1 plus the square of 2 plus square of and the other 2 and square root of the summation is your magnitude. You multiply it by FD, and this is what you get as your vector FD. So the first one for FB, we use the projection angles. FC, we don't need to use anything because it's only one component on the z-axis. And for the FD, I use the position vector, which is the unit vector here. So this, if you need to, you need to find the direction, which is the unit vector of AD, and you multiply it by FD, and that's your force FD in I in Cartesian coordinates. We have all of them. Now we need to construct the equations of equilibrium, the three equations of equilibrium, which are the summation of forces and x equal to zero, y equal to zero, and the z equal to zero. This is summation of forces equal to zero, and we took the two forces, all the three x components from FB, from FC and FD, FY as well equal to zero. You sum all the y components, you sum all the z components, and you come up with these three occasions. So I will call this occasion one, that's two, and it's three. Now we need to find the solution of this system. So this is the system of three scalar occasions, and they all need to be satisfied in order to have our point A at equilibrium. So the simplest way is to do substitution. So if you look at the one, the last one, you need to use one by one. So the last occasion, you see that it's a function of only FD. I have only one unknown. I can move 600 to the other side and it'll be plus. you divide it by the 0.667, and then you have your FD. Once you have your FD, you substitute here with the second equation, and then you will have an equation with only one unknown, which is FB. You do the same, you find FB, and again, you repeat for the third one, and you find your FC. So the solution of all of them is like this. So if you did the substitution, this is what you end up, FC, FD, and FB. Notice that we assumed all forces coming out of the equilibrium point, which is point A. And that's important, actually. We're going to, this, if the assumptions are correct, we will have our values all as are positive, just like what we how we have it here. So as long as they are all positive, it means that our assumption of the force going out is correct. And also they are all in tension, which means that when we say that the forces are in tension, it means that the point A is in tension, which means that if you are pulling point A, that means that A is in tension. Point A is feeling tension. We're going to talk about this more in the class as well. But let me show you how are we going to quickly to solve for these unknowns. I'm just going to do the substitution quickly so that everybody are on the same page. So that's 1, 2, 3. In the exam, once you reach this point, you have you can claim most of the grades. But doing the substitution and finding the real value or the actual value will give you the full grade. So from point 3, from equation 3, this is what we're going to have. So you can see that FD equals, you move the FD, the 600 to the other side, that's positive. And then you divide by 0.667, and your FD actually is going to be 809.955. And if you followed our instruction with the three significant figures, you round the 5 to be 6, and then this one is going to be 900. So that's 900, and don't forget your units in order to have your grade. So once you have FD, you substitute FD into equation 2. So you do equation 2. So what we have is 0.866 FB minus 0.667, and FD we have it as 900 equal to 0. You move this to the other side, it becomes positive. So let me go back and complete this substitution process. So again, to go back, this is occasion number 1 and occasion number 2 and occasion number 3. We need to solve these three occasions in order to get the values of FC, FD, and FB, the one that showed shown to the right of the screen. So to do so, we take one occasion at a time. So starting with occasion number 3, because it has only one unknown, that's the easiest one to go through. So we can see that I can move the minus 600 to the other side. It's become positive. So what we have from occasion 3, so we can go and see that 0.667 FD equals 600. And you divide both sides by the 0.667. 0.667, and this will go together, and you will have FD equals to 899.55. If you round it up for three significant figures, we will end up with 900 newtons. And don't forget these three significant figures, and don't forget your unit. If we did this, so we have FD, I can now take FD, the value, and substitute it in equation number 2 to find FB. So from equation 2, we can say that we have 0.866 FB equals, you move the minus 0.667 FD to the other side. That's what's going to happen. and you will have 0.6. You change their sign to become positive, 6, 7, FD, and we know what FD is, 900, so this is 0.667 multiplied by 900, and you divide both sides here by 0.866, and this is 0.866, and you will end up with FB equals, so it's going to be 692.8, and if you round it up to three significant figures, you'll have 693 newtons, and this is your FB. You do the same for equation number one. I will leave that for you, so you can substitute the FD and FB here. This is your FD and FB. You can move FC to the other side, and then you change its sign, and then you can come up, you'll get up your FC by 646 newtons. I hope this video was helpful, and this example showed you how we build the free body diagram for a three-dimensional static system, and then we construct the equations of equilibrium, and then we solve for the unknown forces that we want to find and calculate. Thank you for watching. Until the next video.